DNA experience.
It's like, no. Assalamualaikum.
Hello guys. Hello.
Hello.
Today I meet Dina again, cause last time I did handshake with you, right? But there was a comment, you can't touch Muslim girls.
Did they say that? You cannot touch Muslim girls.
It was not that offended.
Okay.
There was a comment, so I was curious, really that people cannot touch girls? Because in Korea, shake hands, it's okay. So I was curious, is it really offended? So I'm gonna ask some questions today, so. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
You're ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, let's go. So, first question is it true that men cannot touch women in Muslim culture?
Yes and no. Men and women that are not in the same family should not be having skinship, so they should not be touching. So like my brother, I can hug my brother, my dad,
or family
my
uncle. Is okay.
Yeah, family is okay. Or if I'm married, then I would be like with your husband, obviously, you can hold hands or something. When you're outside of family, then in Islam, it's a no. Like that's the rules say they shouldn't be touching, like men and women shouldn't be touching. But again, this is like the whole practice, you know, not everyone practices that. And so you'll find that a lot of people do still like shake hands or something. I mean, for me, I come from a Western country. And so I'm just used to automatically. It's like an automatic reflex. I'm like, hand. I'm like, oh, wait, what am I doing? So it's like without thinking, I'm just like, oh, wait, what are you doing? Stop.
So you have lived in America. So or you're used to an American culture too.
You shake hands. And in Bosnia, you hug people and then you like kiss them on the cheek, like kind of on the side, like not like mwah, but like on the side, like mwah, mwah.
Like friends.
Yeah. When, not strangers. That would be weird. But if you're close, usually in Bosnia, if it's a guy and a girl, if you're close friends, sometimes you greet each other with a hug. Or like a kiss, or you say bye. I personally don't. But in Bosnia, they do.
I don't.
I get really shy if someone like wants to hug me. I'm like, what are you doing?
Okay, I got it. So if family is okay, but with a stranger or other people, then yeah, it's not allowed, basically.
Yeah.
Okay, I got it. So the next question is, maybe it can be a loot question, but I'm really curious. So why do you think it's not allowed?
Why it's not?
Yeah.
Because, no, I'm not a scholar, but yeah. Like, I feel like I need to say this. Yeah. I'm not a prophet. I'm not
okay.
I don't know everything.
Sure.
But like in Islam, like family relationships are very important. Like,
yeah, right?
And marriage is very important. And committing, you know what adultery is?
What is adultery?
Adultery is when you have sexual relations outside of marriage.
Yeah?
And so that is a big no in Islam. Like, so you're not allowed to have sexual relations outside of marriage in Islam. And so a lot of people think like, oh, it's just a handshake. Oh, it's just a hug. But those things don't always, but can lead to more. So it can start with, oh, it's a handshake. Oh, it's just holding hands. Oh, it's just a hug. Oh, it's just a kiss. And then, you know, you go down the journey. And so Islam, like that doesn't always happen, obviously. Not everyone hands. If you shake someone's hand, that doesn't mean you're going to kiss them or something. That would be funny.
Of course, yeah.
But Islam is more like we don't even want to open that door. Like, it's just like, okay, we're gonna stop everything. We don't even want to go there at all. So Islam's like very, don't even go there.
So I think it's kind of 예방 뭐라지? 예방은 영어로 뭐지? 예방.
저도 몰라요. 죄송합니다.
Just be careful.
Yeah, like be careful. It's like nuclear. Like if something's like nuclear, you don't like, I'm just gonna touch it a little. You're like, no, stay away. That's the rules, but then people don't always practice like that. So yeah, you'll see like different people's cultures or personalities. People don't always follow the rules. So yeah, you'll see Muslim people still hold hands or hug and stuff, even if they're not married. They just don't follow the rules the best. But that's okay. I mean, everyone has their problems. I'm sure they're working on getting better.
I think it's like kinds of seatbelt.
Yeah, it's like the seatbelt. Yeah.
There's a rule, but not everyone follows the rule.
From the last video, which you should watch. Which I'm sure Jay will put somewhere up here.
I'm curious that Muslim people can go abroad and they can live another culture like you. But in another culture, they can try to shake your hands like me or try to skinship. That's possible. So if they do that, then how
do you deal with
Yeah, how do you deal with that?
For me personally, because America has more skinship than in Korea, I think. Because Korea, people usually bow.
Yeah, we like.
Yeah, usually they're like, don't touch me. Bow. Yeah. In America, it's always like, handshake. Look you in the eye, handshake.
Right.
And so I think it's harder in America. But I think really it's like a personal thing. For me personally, when I was in America, every time, like if I remember, sometimes I don't, like if I don't think, I just automatically shake hands. Just like automatic reaction on me. So I have to like stop and think. I'm like, oh no, don't, wait, stop, Dita, stop. So like for me, when I was in America, I would put my hands right here and I'm like, oh, nice to meet you. And people, like, they have their hand out and they're like,
Oh, that's so awkward.
So sometimes I have to like explain sometimes, like, oh, sorry, because I'm Muslim, I don't want to shake hands with men outside of my family. I hope you can understand that. Usually that was like, I didn't really shake hands with people outside of like, maybe like a business meeting. Because when you just catch, like if you meet a friend, like if I met you for the first time in America, people don't usually go, hey, nice to meet you, shake hands.
Yeah, it's not.
Yeah, really it's like only for like business meeting. And so I would explain like in the, like just a mini, if we're going to do something in business, like if it's an interview or something, then I think the person that I'm potentially getting into business with should understand why. But yeah, if you just say it nicely, then people usually understand. In Korea, people really...
They don't try to touch.
Yeah, people, ajumas touch me.
Yeah, right.
But like...
Jimjilbang.
Yeah.
Without clothes.
Yeah, ajumma, they just like, they like to grab my wrist and go, whoa, I'm sick. And I'm like, I met this ajumma like 2 weeks ago. She was trying to set me up with her son. Yeah. You know that? She's like, oh, I have a son your age. He's going to school. This hotali is blah, 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 blah. And I'm just like,
wait, Korean?
Yeah, yeah. It was just a random Korean. And I'm just like, I'm just here to like wash my hair and leave. I'm not here to get married. I'm just gonna go now.
Korean ajummas are too friendly.
I like you so much. I want you to be part of my family. Wait, what was the question? Did I even answer the question?
I forgot.
How do I deal with people shaking my hand? Me mentally, God is the most forgiving. So if you accidentally do it, or even if you purposefully do it, you ask for forgiveness and then try to stop. I think it's okay. Especially if it's an accident and you're like, oh, okay, let me try and remember. Don't do that.
Oh, okay, I got it. I think it can be sensitive question. I heard that in Islamic country, they even cannot date before marriage. Is that true?
Is that true? Islamic country, I don't know. But Islam, in Islam, not allowed to technically touch before marriage. But like, for me personally, I'm like, if I'm just talking, if we're just talking, usually when people like, people who are like really strong in their faith, like if it's like a guy and a girl are on a date, but then there's like a chaperone, a third person, like you come with your mom or with your dad or something, or maybe a friend, and so that you can get to know each other. You mainly just talk and get to know each other, like who are you, like what are your goals, and so usually you just talk to get to know the other person, but like you're not like kissing and doing all of that other stuff. It's more like hanging out like friends in a way, but like you talk more about serious stuff usually. Many Islamic cultures, they usually get straight to the point, like if you're like, hey, let's, like I'm interested in marrying you or something, then usually people, you know, you ask important questions like, do you want kids, how many kids, like are we, if your parents get old, like when your parents get old, are they gonna live with us, like you, like normally, you know, when you go on a date, this not really the first question you ask, right?
Right. That's right.
So it's usually in Islam, it's more like people are like, I like you, I want to marry you. And usually they want to meet your parents usually. They want to meet your dad, or if you don't have a dad, they want to meet your mom so that they can meet your parents, the parents, you and stuff like that. Usually that's how it goes. But it's not always how it goes. Some people still secretly date. I wouldn't recommend it, but I mean, your life, I guess. I think like kissing and like touching and stuff like that, that's not allowed in Islam.
Yeah,
like, I don't know why I keep doing this.
I think it depends on how define the date, maybe.
Yeah, how you define, what do you do during a date?
Just getting to know each other, that's okay.
Exchanging the saliva, DNA exchange.
So today I asked about skinship culture in Muslim. So it was really informative for me because I didn't know about Islamic skinship culture. I'm sorry, I got a cold.
건강하세요.
죄송합니다. So I'm sorry about that. I tried to shake hands last time because I really didn't know about the culture thing.
It's my fault too because I shook his hand back. I'm sorry.
So I'm gonna be careful more, and it was really informative comments because I know new facts about them. So I think it's kind of list number two, because I agree that if you start friendship at first, then it can grow up and yeah, you can be mistake. Thank you for answering me about your opinion, and I hope that not to offend her opinion, because your opinion is your opinion.
Yes, so, yeah, my opinion.
Yeah, and if you think it differently, then just comment. Then I can learn about that too. So different perspective. So thank you today.
Yay! Thank you.
Yeah. Bye.
Bye.
Okay. Bye.
That still look weird.